Remember how frustrating it feels to miss a semicolon in your code? Have you ever wondered, why can't computers just fix the bug if a compiler finds it? Well, I did too. But over several years, I came to realize that this bug in the compiler seems to be an intended feature, and you will see why this is so unexpectedly important.
But what about AI like ChatGPT?
Yes, we'll get to that in this video as well, and explore everything about how bug fixing has evolved. But first, we need to understand why compilers were created in the first place. In the 1940s, the first programmable, general-purpose computer was born. Programming was a physical game, toggling switches, plugging wires till things work. No compiler, no proper syntax. If there is a bug and it broke, you have to figure it out all by yourself. As you can tell, it was very inefficient and mistakes were costly, which was exactly what Grace Hopper thought, who then created the first compiler in 1952. This formed the basis of what allows us to convert higher-level programming languages into machine code. The goal of compilers is simple: translate, fail fast, and don't assume. As they say, assuming makes an ass out of you and me. A wrong guess on a programmer's intent might cause a hidden bug, which is far worse than crashing. Take the code as such. We can see a missing end brace. The compiler knows the problem too, but it cannot be sure where to place it. It could be here, there, or even here. Depending on where the brace is placed, it leads to three very different outcomes. This is why compilers only focus on catching syntax errors when translating high-level code to machine ones. But people wanted more, which is why linters were invented. It was created at Bell Labs to check for bugs and style problems for the C language in the 1970s. Linters are special in many ways. While compilers run at compile time, linters do so before compilation. Linters also adopt a more gentle parenting-like style, advising you on mistakes through static analysis, but won't block your code from running. They use heuristics to check for bugs like unused variables, style violations, and code smells. Compilers, on the other hand, forcefully stops everything if there's an error. Understandably so, since it is simply unable to execute its translation task as it attempts to compile your code. In summary, compilers are the grammar checkers of programming languages, only highlighting errors for syntax. Linters are a small upgrade, like having a Grammarly add-on which suggests fixes. But this still doesn't solve the problem of the lack of intent. Something is still missing. Context. Which brings us to AI. The AI coding tools today can solve many bugs that we humans introduce and fix the code on its own. It wasn't possible in the past until this one paper. Essentially, it introduced two key concepts: the transformer architecture and the self-attention mechanism. The former presents a new machine learning model optimized for sequence processing, such as text and code. Before transformers, older models like LSTMs processed text one word at a time. This is slow, and it was also difficult to remember long-range dependencies within sentences. Transformers solve that by allowing it to look at all words at once. Then, self-attention is used to capture the relationship between words within a sentence, even when they are distant. This self-attention mechanism is what we humans know as context. With this paper, transformers evolved to become GPTs, powering numerous AI models that are the foundation of coding tools today. Through prompts and now even agents, we can go pretty far. LLMs can now read full repositories for context, search the web, and emulate a human programmer to a large extent. But it is still not completely autonomous and guaranteed that the bug will be fixed the right way. After all, the ideas in our minds still need to be translated into words in documentation or code. That in itself is a noisy channel and potentially inaccurate. So perhaps the problem lies in the fact that language in itself is up to interpretation, and there is still tons of wiggle room to make a mistake or describe something that isn't exactly what you want. In the end, to answer the question, why can't computers just fix its own bugs? The answer lies in how we look at it. Compilers? Definitely not. Linters? Just a soft suggestion. But modern AI these days? Maybe it can to some degree. But at least for now, it seems that it still requires us humans to be in the loop to account for the things they can't handle. If you are curious to how you can trick AI, or learn about the device that powers it all, watch the next videos here. Thank you so much for watching.